Blackstone Publishing presents Like to Die by David Housewright. This book is read by Brent Hinkley. For Renee. The state of man does change and vary, now sound, now sick, now blithe, now sorry, now dancing merry, now like to die. William Dunbar, Lament for the Makers. 1. My inner voice screamed at me, "Don't do it. Do not do it." I studied the face across the table from me, the smirk. How I wanted to wipe that smirk off that face. It's a trap. You know that, right? No, I don't know that, I told myself. Yes, you do. Dave Deese leaned forward and smirked some more. I'm supposed to sit here all night? He asked. Show me something, McKenzie. He's trying to goad you into making a mistake. I tossed 3 red chips into the center of the table. Call, I said. Deese's smirk became a smile. He threw his cards down. 3 jacks. Damn it. I laid down my own cards, a pair of 10s. Deese rubbed his hands together in delight and dragged the pot toward him. You are the worst poker player I've ever seen, said Bobby Dunstan. That is so untrue. I pointed at the man sitting next to Deese. Ian hasn't won a game since college. Actually, I was the big winner last month, Ian Gott said. I didn't make a fuss about it because, unlike you guys, I don't have self-esteem issues. You're an accountant, Harry said. Of course you have self-esteem issues. Says the man who carries a gun wherever he goes. I'm a special agent of the Federal Bureau of Investigation. It's required. Whose deal is it? Ian pointed at Bobby Dunstan. How about you? The St. Paul Police Department makes the same demands, he said. And you? Gotts was pointing at me. I never carry when I play poker for fear of shooting Dave. Ha, Deese said. He gathered the cards together and started shuffling. What's your point? Harry asked. Penis envy, Ian said. Excuse me? What? Have you guys ever shown each other your guns to see which is bigger? Bobby and Harry stared at each other for a beat. Mine is, Harry said, U.S. government issue. Bobby thought that was awfully funny. It's not how big your gun is, I said. It's how well you use it. Is that what Nina tells you? Deese asked. Let's not go there. Talk about self-esteem issues, said Harry, whose real name was Brian Wilson. Same as the Beach Boy, but who everybody called Harry because of his uncanny resemblance to the character actor Harry Dean Stanton. 5-card draw, Deese said. Aces wild, jacks to open, trips to win. Is it even possible for you to play a straight game of poker? Bobby said. Dealer's choice. Are you the dealer? Ante up, boys. Ante. We played 3 more hands. I lost them all. You know, it's okay to throw in your cards every once in a while, Bobby said. You don't have to play every hand. I only play when I have decent cards, I said. The trouble is, you think all of your cards are decent. McKenzie's an eternal optimist, Deese said. Do I call you names? I asked. Last hand, Harry suggested. Why last hand? Deese wanted to know. Because it's late and I'm still ahead. I knew there had to be a good reason. Hey, Ian said. His eyes flew from Bobby to me. Before you guys leave, can I talk to you? That sounds ominous, Harry said. Sure, I said. What about? Bobby asked. You have a problem? Not me, Ian said. Erin Peterson. Salsa girl? Deese said. What about her? Bobby asked. Someone's messing with her, Ian said. You mean someone besides you? Deese said. Cut it out. This is serious. How serious? I asked. Yesterday, someone filled all of the locks in her building with superglue. She had to call a locksmith to have them drilled out and replaced before her employees could get inside to work. It was a big deal because Friday is when she loads the reefers that deliver her product throughout the Midwest. It put her way behind schedule. She had to pay overtime to get her salsa out. "What's a reefer?" Dees asked. "Refrigerated semi-trailer," I said. "Look at you knowing how things work," Harry said. "Her business is located off University near Raymond, right?" Bobby said. "That's the Western District. Who'd she talk to?" "No one," Ian said. "Erin never called it in. Why not?"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.